You saw what he said. We're going to watch it again because, sure. Look, Kirk Cameron left no doubt as to how he feels about gay marriage and homosexuality. Let's watch what he told Piers Morgan.
I think that it's unnatural. I think that it's detrimental and ultimately destructive to so many of the foundations of civilization.
Okay, Stephen, right after that interview aired, you tweeted your support for Kirk Cameron. Why'd you do that?
Yes, I did. Well, I am here to support Kirk Cameron just because I think it's important that he has the right to stand up and voice what he believes in. You know, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. You know, Rush Limbaugh recently was going for one intention, thought he was being this, it backfired. I don't think that this is the same situation. Let's be honest, AJ. Let's be honest about one thing.
Let's be honest. He answered a question. He answered a question very straightforward.
When you say you're born again and Christian in Hollywood, there's things that are going to come against you.
Of course.
No matter what you do.
Of course, but let's be clear about something that you just said, because I want to make sure I'm not misinterpreting you.
Sure.
You said it's how you say it.
Right.
He couldn't have said it any more plainly. He answered a question about exactly how he feels about gay marriage and homosexuality.
Correct. When Kirk Cameron said, and ultimately the civilization, what he means is, according to the Christian faith, the nuclear family is the origin of what this country was founded upon.
I think he was...
Okay.
I think it's subject to interpretation. But,
right. But okay. You understand what I'm saying?
I hear what you're saying.
So there is marriage between a man and a woman and a mother and a father and children and all
that. Okay.
That's obviously changing.
Let's hear from George, because George, going to Stephen's point, he said, Kirk Cameron said, that homosexuality and gay marriage are detrimental, unnatural, ultimately destructive to the foundations of civilization. Putting aside what Stephen thinks he may have intended to say, based on what we heard him say, if Kirk Cameron were sitting here right now, what would you say to him?
Well, both Kirk Cameron and for Stephen, you know, I respect your right to your opinions.
Sure.
But we have to remember, yours is a faith-based opinion.
Correct.
And what we're talking about is civil law, apart from your faith. And you have to recognize that... if you want respect from us for your faith, respect has to be mutual.
Sure.
And there are many faiths in this society that we live in.
Absolutely.
And so we have a line that draws between church and state. And we're talking about civil law.
Sure.
And to have prejudicial and discriminatory laws that prevent equality in civil law for people who are gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender, mm-hmm. is not right. In the same way,
sure.
that, you know, when this nation was founded, there was no role for women in the institutions of American
women
society.
Couldn't vote.
Sure.
They couldn't vote. They had to struggle for it. Mm-hmm. And it's that kind of struggle that the GLBT community is going through now.
Listen,
for equality in the civil arena.
Of the people I've worked with 25 years, I love them, dearest in the world, live a gay lifestyle.
It's not a lifestyle, it's an orientation.
Okay.
It's like a surfer lifestyle. No, it isn't that.
Orientation. Okay, an inborn.
Yes.
So when Cynthia Nixon said it's a choice, where's everybody asking her about what she means by that, and is that right or wrong, or can somebody help me with that?
Well, I haven't had a discussion with her, but this is very personal.
Well, what's interesting
to me.
Kirk Cameron says this thing, and the media goes nuts.
Well, let me reel it back.
It's a little unbalanced.
Let me reel it back. It's not, and I actually think, and this may sound strange, it's almost a good thing that Kirk said what he said, because I'm watching the backlash today.
Sure.
And the backlash that's been going on since he said that. And basically, the amount of backlash is only reinforcing what an archaic way of thinking it is, and how, to George's point, people who have thought this way in the past have always fallen on the wrong side of history.
I think that not everybody is as equipped to have this conversation. And I don't even qualify myself as really being some expert in Christianity, this and that. I could just tell you this, that I live by a faith that says God has a gift for everyone, even George. And let me tell you something, there are ministries within the homosexual community. I have met men who were married, became homosexual, came out of the homosexual life, came back into a heterosexual. guys, we could talk about it until Jesus comes back.
And if I had that amount of time, but I don't. And look, there's a lot to be said on this.
But we're a kindred spirit here. We both got fired by Trump.
But I do have to leave it.
This is a very personal issue.
I do have to leave it at that.
We're not kindred in that.
George, I know you plan to sit down with Trump about this very issue. We'll talk about that in just a moment. But for now, Steve and George, thank you both very much.